And the good news here is it does appear that it's moving further away from Central Florida, but we're going to feel the impact, Jason.
No, absolutely. We needed to start making that turn, because if you just looked at it right now, it's tracking northwest. If it stayed on that path, it'd be bad news for Florida. But you see right now, an up-close look at that satellite picture shows a major hurricane that just went right over Crooked Island, 115-mile-an-hour winds in that eyewall. So a very dangerous situation for the Bahamas. Now, let's talk about our coastal impacts, because we're going to have a major hurricane closest approach about 210 miles east of Cape Canaveral. Nevertheless, a lot of that swell, the dangerous rip currents and the surf building. We will still get a few tropical storm gusts right along the shore. Severe beach erosion is possible, though, Thursday, Friday, Saturday at times of high tide, which is early in the morning, 5, 6 a.m., and then about 6 p.m. Each day. Now, the wind forecast, this is from the National Hurricane Center, does show the tropical storm force wind staying well offshore. But as I mentioned, in those heavier rains that come around, those outer bands on the backside of Irene, we could get some quick gusts to tropical storm force right up and down U.S. 1 and 95. Around Orlando and Kissimmee, 10 to 20-mile-an-hour winds starting Thursday afternoon and lasting into early Friday, could get some 30-mile-an-hour gusts, but nothing that would do any damage, so just a blustery day. The rain outlook, really, this one's not going to be a rain legacy. It's passing east of us, but we could get a quick inch of rain right there along the Brevard coastline, half an inch to an inch from basically Sanford eastward, lesser amounts going west. We won't have much rain other than a few quick passing downpours. Now, temperatures are in the mid to upper 80s right now. Actually, we're running a few degrees lower than yesterday, and there is some drier air sinking down from the north. So just a few storms today moving westward. The bigger story, I think, the rip current risk beginning to increase already, and it's only going to go sky high through the end of the week. Now, high temperatures today holding in the upper 80s and low 90s near normal most spots, and you see those spotty showers trying to crop up with the heat of the day moving from east to west. Fairly quiet evening out there. And then as you head into the overnight, some of those coastal showers coming in on the backside of Irene as she makes her way northward out of the Bahamas. So we'll be watching out for those heavier coastal rains, a possibility into tomorrow and into early Friday before the west winds come in and move all that rain off the coast and eventually out over the Atlantic. And then we start to heat up and dry out for the weekend. Meantime, your 7-day forecast, temperatures hovering about 90 at 5 o'clock and then coming down into the evening as those east winds take over and our sea breeze comes by. You'll see Thursday with a chance of rain really at any time during the day as those fast-moving showers from east to west are going to be coming in on the backside of Irene. Then rain chances begin to shut down late Friday and go down to 30% again for the weekend. Jason Seale.